In this video, we'll learn how to draw Bezier curves with code in p5js. Bezier curves are the same exact type of curves that we draw in Illustrator when we use the pen tool. Drawing Bezier curves with code allows you to bring in organic or irregular shapes into your p5js sketch. We can use the Bezier function call to draw individual path segments. Here's how it works. Bezier takes in 8 total arguments, which are the horizontal and vertical coordinates of the 4 points that define one vector path segment. The first anchor point, the first control handle, the second control handle, and the second anchor point. To practice drawing Bezier curves with code, I've got Illustrator open with the file samplecurves.ai from this week's demo files. Here I've got a curve that I'd like to duplicate with code. So what we'll do here is get the X and Y coordinates of the anchor points and control handles from Illustrator, then feed those into the Bezier function call in our code. To get set up, first I'll set my units to pixels by right-clicking on the ruler and selecting pixels. You could also do this by going to preferences if your rulers aren't visible. Then under the view menu, I'll make sure that smart guides are enabled. Then I'll click window, info from the menu bar, and finally, click on the pen tool in the toolbar. Notice as I move the pen tool, the info panel shows its artboard coordinates in X for horizontal and Y for vertical. I need to get the coordinates of the anchor points and the control handles of this path segment, so I'll need to select it. And I can do that by holding Command or Control on the keyboard and clicking anywhere along the path segment. So I can see this first anchor point is about 139 pixels in the X dimension and 164 in the Y dimension. So let's go into P5, and in my draw block, I'll start that Bezier function call, and then I'll type in my first two coordinates. So I have 139, comma 164. I'll click back to Illustrator, and let's look at this first control handle. So I can see that's about 134, X and 156 Y. So I'll type that in, then back to Illustrator, and let's get the second control handle. So that looks like it's about 107 X and 93 Y. Type that into my code, and then finally back to Illustrator to get the second anchor point, which looks like it's about 208 in the X and 101 in the Y. And we'll just type that in to P5, and let's not forget our semicolon at the end of the line. I'll go ahead and click play, and I can see I've got my path segment. So that's how it works for one individual path segment. I can also chain multiple curves together, like we see in this open multi-curve layer of our Illustrator file. I'll go ahead and use a second Bezier function call in my code to bring in this adjacent path segment. Now notice that the first anchor point of the adjacent segment is also the second anchor point of the previous path I just drew. So I can actually just copy those coordinates since they're the same point. Then I'll use my pen tool to get the others from Illustrator. Notice there's no control handle for this last anchor point. So I'll use the anchor points coordinates for the third and the fourth set of arguments. Now I've got a continuous curve, and maybe that's as far as I need to go. I do also have the option of making a fully enclosed Bezier shape, which would make it easier to set an interior fill just like we can in Illustrator. I can see an example of exactly that type of curve in the closed multi-curve layer of our demo file. I'll need some slightly different function calls in my code, but overall my approach is very similar to what we've covered so far. So in my P5 editor, I'll comment out the two lines that have my Bezier function calls. So we start and end the code for a closed Bezier shape with the begin shape and the end shape function calls. In between, we'll use a couple different function calls to draw out the path segments that make up our closed shape. I'll start with a vertex function call, and this sets just the very first anchor point of the shape. And I can copy that right from my commented code. The other three points go into a Bezier vertex function call, which is similar to the Bezier function, except that it only takes the first control handle, the second control handle, and the second anchor point of the path segment. And it works this way so that we don't end up having to duplicate the points of adjacent path segments, since we know that they'll share at least one endpoint. I'll spend some time getting the other three segments set up. And then the last anchor point of the last path segment should match exactly with the coordinates of our vertex function call. And that's what makes it a closed off shape. Okay, that's how to draw Bezier curves with code in p5.js.